Hello everyone, my name is Jimmy Barrera. I'm a SolidWorks Elite Application Engineer with Cimquest, and today I'm going to show you some pretty cool functionality regarding surfacing. Not really anything new, but just functionality that people don't know exists in SolidWorks. A lot of people have thought that SolidWorks is only a solid modeling program, but today I'm going to show you that it's far from that. Over the years, SolidWorks has invested into creating a lot of pretty advanced functionality regarding surfacing. I'm going to use this carving knife demo in order to show you that. Notice that this carving knife assembly is a working assembly. If I zoom into this section here, I can actually grab some of these gears and components. And as I move them, the whole assembly moves in motion. It's pretty one of the pretty cool things in SolidWorks. However, notice that the design is not yet completed. We need a cover for this. To cover all these components, basically a knife handle. I do have some artist rendering or sketches of what the artist thought this should look like. Notice that from the right side here, we have this profile view, and also from the top view, we have another profile view. So we're going to use those in order to get exactly the shape that we want. All right, so let's get started. I have a part in here that I'm going to go ahead and edit so I can actually create this in the context of the assembly. Let me go ahead and zoom into this section. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start copying the contours of this picture. So this picture is on the right plane, so I'm going to go ahead and start a sketch on the right plane and use my splines. I'm going to attempt to do a three-point spline. And I'm just tracing over this picture. That's another common question that some of our prospects or customers have. Can you import a picture and trace it? Yes, this is exactly what we're doing here. So I'm taking these two points, I'm going to add a relationship just to make sure those two are lined up. And I'm pretty much done with this sketch, so I'm going to go ahead and exit it. Now, I'm going to add another sketch on the front plane that bisects this point exactly where that meets because of the relationship I just added. And this is going to be an arc. So let's go to my sketches here. And I'm going to use maybe like a center point arc. I'm going to make sure it's attached to this start point. Create my semicircle, line up my endpoints, make sure that they're all vertical in respect to this origin. That just makes sure everything's nicely lined up. I'm finished with this sketch, and now I can start my first surface. If I go into my surfacing commands, I can use a swept surface. Here's my profile. Here's my path. And notice that it doesn't sweep exactly how I want it to. This is a default. Basically, what it's doing is taking this profile and sweeping it, and it's curving along the path. Well, I want to change the default. Instead of following the path, I want to keep it. I want to keep the normal constant so it stays vertical, straight up and down as it sweeps along the path. You will notice that SolidWorks has a lot of different twist types or orientation types as you create these sweeps. Okay, I'm pretty happy with this. I'm going to accept that. But I still have a lot of work to do, as you can see. I have a belly here that I have to create, and also I have to bring this in just a little bit. And the same thing with the top side. I have a belly here that I have to create. So with SolidWorks surfacing, this is very easy to do. Let's start from the side first. So I'm going to start from this side. I'm going to zoom into this section. And I'm going to start using what we call freeform. So using SolidWorks freeform, I'm able to create a grid right on this surface here. Just going to go ahead and turn off these curvature combs, which we're going to use later on. I'm going to make this surface transparent just so I can see through it. I can see what I actually need and don't need, how much material I have that's extra, which later on I can just chop it off. All right, that's pretty good there. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add some control points. All right, so we're going to make sure everything's ready to go. I'm going to add some end conditions here just so it knows how these edges are going to relate to the surfaces that are going to be connected to them. So for example, I want curvature continuity here. I'm going to add a couple of end conditions here. And once I do that, now I can add points. For example, I can add points down here. And maybe a couple more points over here. Now, I'm noticing that my sweep is a little large. So I'm going to go ahead and exit this and just change my sketch just a little bit, because this is parametric. It shouldn't be that difficult to do. I'm going to go ahead and edit this sketch. And it's just by clicking on it, I can change the distance of this guy down here. I'm going to go ahead and make it maybe 32, nice even number. And as soon as I exit this, everything updates accordingly. Now that pretty much follows the thickness that I want. Okay, so back to the freeform surface. I'm going to go ahead and select that surface there again and add my end conditions. Now I can add my points. I'm going to add one right here where I want to press the material inside a little bit. Now these are approximations. It's freeform. So it's giving me leverage to do basically whatever I want here. Okay, I like this setup there. I'm going to go ahead and take these two points and pull this down just a little bit. Try that one once again here. So with my control key, I'm going to go ahead and manipulate this. And notice how very easily I'm able to tug and pull on this part of the material. Same thing here. I'm going to just bring this out just a little bit and maybe take this tangency arrow and manipulate that as well. Because of this condition here, movable tangent, I can move this edge around, but also is maintaining tangency between all the control points that I've added. We do the same thing to this guy, push it in just a little bit, and I'm pretty happy with that. All right, so we've changed the contour on the surface, but notice from the top, I still got some work to do there. So in order to fix that, I'm going to add a curve, which then later on I can add points to that curve. So I'm going to take this maybe outermost point here, so adding a curve pretty much around the middle there. If I hit escape right away and I go back into that curve, notice it copied the control points at just the identical portions of that curve, just like I did on this curve here. So it makes it a lot easier to follow the same shape all the way through. So I'm going to look at this from the top, and this way I can see what I'm doing. I'm going to take this guy and this guy, and the same thing, I'm going to go ahead and bring them out. Pretty happy with that. I'm going to just take this guy and do the same thing, bring it out just a little bit, and then take this tangency arrow and move this just like so. And the last thing is just belly this in just a little bit. All right. Let me see here. All right, pretty happy with that. Let's get a nice symmetric view here. And notice that this is pretty good. Before I exit this, I want to check the quality of my surface, and that's what I use the curvature combs for. I notice that the size of these combs are pretty much the same until it gets to the end, and they kind of spike. So I don't like that. I want to make sure that the curvature continuity is pretty uniform throughout. So it's an easy fix using SolidWorks. I can add another curve maybe around this area here. And if I hit escape again, I'm able to go into that curve and select my two control points, grab the arrow and pull it out just a little bit, and notice how very quickly those spikes shrink. And that looks very good there. I'm going to do the same thing to the bottom half. So I'm going to add another curve around there. I'm going to hit my escape key, go back into that curve, and grab these two points and pull them towards me a little bit. All right, it's very delicate, so you got to be very careful here. And if I pull in just a little bit, pretty happy with that. Make sure the spikes are not going the other way, because that'll give me the wrong result. All right, that looks pretty good. I'm going to accept this, and notice the quality of my surface is very, very nice. This is a complex surface here, not your average shape that you would get from a regular sketch and extrude. All right, so at this point, I'm going to go ahead and trim this. I already have a sketch that I can do that with that I created beforehand. It's just a simple two-line sketch. just to speed things up just a little bit. And using that sketch, I can use my trim function. So I'm going to go over here and use a trim surface. Using that sketch, I can choose whether to keep or remove. I'm going to remove this section, and very quickly, it does that for me. And that's just because I don't need all this excess material. I'm noticing that because I'm actually inside the assembly as I'm modeling. So I can cut on cost right there. All right, I'm going to go ahead and cap this off by just using a filled surface. I can click on this one edge. It does all the work for me. It optimizes the surface. Fix up boundary allows me to just let SolidWorks create this edge for me, and I don't have to create that extra geometry there. I'm going to merge the result so these two surfaces become one after I click OK. All right, that's pretty good there, and I'm pretty much done with my sketches, so I'm going to go ahead and turn those off real quick. Okay, I'm pretty happy with this. The last thing I'm going to do is mirror this. So I can use the right plane and then just go into my mirror command very quickly. And I'm going to mirror this body and go ahead and knit the surfaces as I do that. Okay, so I have this as one surface. Let me just open this up in its own file. Make sure I can see this. There it goes. It was hidden for a little bit. Now, here's a true test. All those end conditions that I use here, the continuity conditions, I use curvature continuous here, which means that if I turn off the edges and I go into zebra stripe mode, I should not be able to see an edge there. So let's see if that worked out the way we intended. Look at that. So you have no idea where that edge is. I can see how my curvature line starts here. It continues. There's continuity all the way throughout. It doesn't change the direction sharply, which means not only does it have true tangency, but it has true curvature continuity. This is exactly what I was looking for. And with SolidWorks, I was able to do that pretty simply in about 10, 12 minutes. So, of course, as I'm explaining as this goes along, I'm showing you each step of the way. If I didn't have to explain it, it would go a lot quicker. But this is just a very quick summary of the power in SolidWorks surfacing. Just as a review, we saw the surface sweep conditions that we can use. In this case, we use keep normal constant. We also saw some of the cool stuff from the Freeform tool, how to add points, curves, control points, and how to tug and pull your surface to get it just the way you wanted it. And then we did a surface fill here at the end, which is very nice. We didn't have to create this edge here. And at the end, we just mirrored this. Now it's pretty easy. We can just cap off the front and the back, turn it into a solid, and keep going with our design. So hopefully in these few minutes, you were able to see some of the cool stuff that SolidWorks has to offer regarding surfacing. That's it for this time. We'll see you next time. And thanks for joining us today in this session for SolidWorks surfacing. Take care.